New Zealand's had a strong relationship with the Pacific for many years, and that's why earlier this month, Prime Minister John Key was keen to visit the region in a four-country and four-day tour. Adrian Stevenon has the story.
A Tongan welcome for John Key, together with his wife, fellow MPs, officials and a hip-hop dance group. It was his first official visit to the region.
I think it's important New Zealand plays a leadership role in the Pacific. We have done so for a long period of time.
First stop, a meeting with King Seosi Tupounima, Prime Minister bearing gifts. An extra $6 million on top of the $12 million aid to Tonga by 2011. Some of it to help pave the way for democratic reform.
It's an important part of ensuring that the process can operate smoothly.
Well, I think it's
for their part,
future.
The Tongans are on track for their first election under a reform constitution late next year.
Much of the fundamental changes have already been effected.
From Tonga, it was on to Samoa, where the locals were taking extra swine flu precautions, probably why John Key promised Tamiflu to Samoa. The welcoming committee kicked in before a visit to the head of state, followed by a meeting with Samoa's Prime Minister before this announcement.
New Zealand intends to increase its aid budget to Samoa. Currently it's $10.5 million per year. This year it will be rising to $14 million, next year to $15 million, and the year after to $17 million.
Also on the tour, former All Blacks Tuingamala, Vainga Tuingamala and La'auli Michael Jones, big supporters of the PM at the last election, happy to lend their support.
This is one way of really just John Key and the New Zealand government really just reassuring the Pacific Islands that you know they're there to support them.
In Niue, Mr. Key was welcomed like royalty, but it was the ex-All Blacks who were treated like stars. So too were the travelling hip-hop group. Meantime, Mr. Key was on a dance of his own around Niue Prime Minister Tuke Talangi.
We don't have a fundamental difference. We both agree that we should release the funds. We both agree we've got to count for those funds, but the funds have got to be released. They should not take so long, and he and I agree on that.
The funds in question, a $4 million aid package for tourism. New Zealand wants assurances it'll be spent properly. Niue keeping its options open.
We've got to look elsewhere if we're not able to access those funds from New Zealand.
And would you be looking at China, for example?
Yes, we are.
We also have a responsibility to the New Zealand taxpayer to make sure that there's a sound foundation for the requests, that they're going to achieve the outcomes that everybody hopes for.
The discomfort of Niue behind him, Mr. Key in the Cook Islands grabbed his rugby ball and two ex-All Blacks to press the flesh at a local sports academy run by Kiwi League legend Kevin Edel. Then it was off to sign an agreement, effectively kicking into touch the Cook status as a tax haven.
From New Zealand's point of view, it'll allow our tax authorities and Land Revenue Department to be able to seek information here in the Cook Islands if someone is, we believe, actively engaging in tax evasion.
Once again, Mr. Key came bearing extra aid money. The irony, he'll probably get it all back from Kiwi companies no longer able to use the Cooks to dodge taxes. A nice way to end a whirlwind tour.
And John Key's next meeting with Pacific leaders will be at their forum meeting in Cairns next month.